Hello, my name is Mike Kösta. I'm training consultant at Rothenberger, and I take care of everything related to the technical training seminars. For the pressure testing of an air conditioning system, you need the following products. First, our digital manifold, including refrigerant hoses, a nitrogen pressure reducer, and, last but not least, a bottle of dry nitrogen. The first step of the commissioning is the load test to maximum pressure. The maximum pressure of a system can be found on the manufacturer's specification plate. In this case, it is indicated as 43 bar. A pressure reducer is connected to the nitrogen cylinder. The pressure reducer is equipped with two pressure gauges. The pressure gauge facing the cylinder indicates the cylinder pressure. Working pressure is indicated on the manometer that stands out. In refrigeration technology, only dry nitrogen with a quality class of at least 4.6 is used. Now, the yellow working hose, which is connected to the middle connection of the Rohkühl, is attached to our pressure reducer. Blue working hose is attached to the low pressure side of the Rohkühl 600 and to the service valve of the air conditioner. All shutoff valves are closed. Now, the required working pressure can be set and taken from our working pressure gauge, in this case 43 bar. Next, the shutoff valve on the working hose is opened. The shutoff valve on our blue test and measuring hose is then open. Now, the dry nitrogen can flow into the air conditioning system in a controlled way via the yellow working hose and the working valve. The air conditioning system has been pressurized with dry nitrogen at the maximum operating pressure. Our working valve is closed for the measuring process. The system is tight, and the nitrogen can be lowered to working pressure level. For this purpose, the working valve on the low pressure side is opened. Then, the valve on the high pressure side is opened, and the nitrogen flows out. This was the load test. The load test is carried out for approximately 30 minutes, unless otherwise specified by the manufacturer. After this load test, the leak test is performed. How is the working pressure selected? From the air conditioning application, it is known that temperatures on the low pressure side of 0 to approximately plus 10 degrees Celsius are to be expected. And from this, the required test pressure for the leak test is derived. Here it can be seen that the refrigerant R410A is associated with a saturation temperature of 5.2 degrees Celsius at the pressure of 8.39 bar. The leak test is performed for approximately 60 minutes, unless otherwise specified by the manufacturer. Please refer to the manufacturer's installation instructions. If this specifies a longer period, the leak test must be carried out over this period at least. In another tutorial, we will show how to evacuate an air conditioning system. Thanks for watching.